Hello everyone, I'm Nikhil Thomas. I'm a software engineer at Red Hat. So this talk is about building a cloud-native CI/CD pipelines with Tecton on Kubernetes. So this is going to be the contents of this talk. So I'll introduce you to the app and the CI/CD pipeline that we are going to build. I will introduce you to Tecton pipeline, and I'll show you a demo on how to build the pipeline. So this is going to be a sample app that we are going to work with. So it has two web services. So we can make a request to the web service one. It will call the second web service and send us back a response. And this is going to be the CI/CD pipeline that we are going to build. It basically has four stages. So we have to build the web service one. We have to build web service two. And we have to deploy the web service one and two on a Kubernetes cluster. The input for building the web service is source code from a GitHub repository. And when you build the images, we feed it to the deploy step, and it will deploy as a Kubernetes deployment. So this is a snapshot of Tecton website. So something on this page totally stands out for me. It's not the banner, but it is this. Tecton pipelines, Kubernetes style resources, and declaring CI/CD pipelines. So Tecton basically provides you with a set of custom resources using which you can create Kubernetes style CI/CD resources. And Tecton provides you a controller which will manage the state of your CI/CD pipelines for you. About a year back, Daniel Smith, in a talk, Kubernetes-style APIs of the future, said, Kubernetes resource model is coming to you on API near you. So when I heard that first, I didn't actually get what it meant. But when I started working with Tecton, it made more sense. So in Kubernetes resource model, so we have API operations and state. So the API operations are managed using predefined resources. And we have a set of verbs which we can apply on them. So we are familiar with resources like pods, deployments. And the beauty of this model is that if you know how to work with a pod, you know how to work with a deployment. If you know how to create or edit a pod, you can do the same with a deployment, service, etc. So Kubernetes allows you to extend your cluster by adding custom resources. So we add this using CRDs, or custom resource definitions. And the state in a Kubernetes cluster is managed using controllers. So instead of managing the state as a whole, what Kubernetes does is it will split the state into smaller pieces, and separate controllers manage separate pieces of the state. Yes, and Tecton provides you a controller, and that's a custom controller which will extend your Kubernetes clusters for CI/CD. So under Tecton.org, there are many projects, and I'm going to be talking about pipelines and CLI. So again, this is the CI/CD pipeline that we are going to build. So to build this, these are the custom resources provided by Tecton that we are going to use. So we have task, pipeline resource, pipeline, a task run, and a pipeline run. So these stages that we see here are tasks. So the way we define a task is using the CRD task. And it defines the work in a stage that needs to be executed. And every task is launched on a Kubernetes cluster as a pod. And it contains multiple steps. So a step in a task is a series of commands. And it is sequentially executed. And each step runs as a container. So you can see here, so when you define a task, so steps is a list of container, or it is a container template where you can specify a list of commands that you need to execute for this task. So a task can take inputs and outputs. The inputs can be pipeline resources or parameters. An output can be pipeline resources. Pipeline resource is another type defined by Tecton. So it abstracts certain commonly used resources such as Git repository, container images, storage, etc. So in a task, so we specify the inputs and the input resources, parameters, and output resources. So the next thing that we need to define are the pipeline resource. So here we know that the input for the build stage is a Git repository. So we will represent that using a Git pipeline resource. And the container images are represented using an image pipeline resource. So a pipeline resource is a predefined input and output. So it is system-defined resource types that is ready to use. So Tecton knows about these types, and it knows what to do with them when you define an instance of these types. So they are decoupled and reusable. That means a pipeline resource can be used with different tasks. Commonly used types are image and Git. So this is how the definition for a pipeline resource will look like. So this is the definition of a Git type, and it represents this particular GitHub repository. And this is a pipeline resource of type image, and it points to one particular image. So next thing that we need to define is the pipeline itself. So we have to chain together these tasks. A pipeline is a chain of tasks. So it's an direct acyclic graph. So that means you can specify some order, and the task will be executed in that order. So this is how you will define a pipeline. So we define it using the CRD pipeline, and we have a list of tasks that can be referenced so that the pipeline knows which are the stages inside the pipeline. So the next two resources that we are going to create are runtime resources. So when you have a task, you can couple it with different inputs and outputs, and you can run it multiple times. So a task run is an instance of a defined task. It will bind inputs and outputs to a particular task. It can also set the values of parameters and execute the steps. So this is an example for a task run. So it references a task by its name. It provides inputs, parameters, and outputs. So just like task run, a pipeline run is an invocation of a pipeline. So it binds inputs and outputs to a pipeline. It will execute the task in a pipeline and create task runs for each stages. So this is of kind pipeline, and it will reference a pipeline by its name. This is a pipeline run which will reference a pipeline by its name and bind the resources for it. So let me try to build the CI/CD pipeline and deploy the sample app. So like we saw before, we have two web services that we need to build and deploy. The first thing that we are going to do is create the build task. So it has three stages. We need to pull the source code, build the container image, and push it to a container registry. The deployment task takes a deployment manifest, and it has to fill in the image URL for the image that we just created and create the deployment. So first, let's see how to create the pipeline resource. Okay, so this is my code for the pipeline. So here, what we have is three pipeline resources. So this is a pipeline resource of type Git. It is called Git, and it points to this particular URL. This is the source code of the sample application. The service one is called web.go, and the service two is called app.go. So it also has two Docker files to build the app, and two deployment manifests, which is a simple manifest where we need to replace this image after building the image. So this pipeline resource points to that repository. And we have a pipeline resource called image app. And it's of type image. And it points to this container registry URL. So after building the image for the web service 2, it will push the image to this URL. First, I'm going to create the pipeline resources. So it's created. So we created the pipeline resource for the source code, as well as the pipeline resources for the container images. The next thing that we need to do is to create the build task. The build tasks are defined here. So this is a task to build the app image. So it looks for an input resource called Git, which we just created. And it takes in two parameters as input. So one is the path for the Docker file, and the second one is a path to the context of Docker build. And it will output an image. So it builds, there is only one step. So it will build the image using Kaniko, using this Git input resource and outputting this image pipeline resource. This is a similar task, but which will build the image for the second web service. And we have a task that is to deploy the image as a deployment. So what it takes in is the Git repository, and the first image, the second image, and the parameters. Those are the path to the deployments, the deployment manifest, and the path to the image. So basically what it will do is it will read this file and it will find this image tag and it will replace it with the image that we just built. So we will replace the image, and the last two steps is a kubectl apply or create deployment. So we'll create those three tasks. Okay, so we created the two tasks. And now we have to define the pipeline. The pipeline is defined here. It is of kind pipeline. It will reference the task that the build app image and then the build web image. It will specify the inputs and outputs. Input is source code and output is an image. The same thing for building the web image. And then it will call the deploy task. And it will provide the two build images and the source repository for the deployment manifest. Okay. Now, what we need to do is run the pipeline. So we do that by creating a pipeline run. So that is an instance of pipeline which is running. So we will connect the pipeline to the input resources and output resources and run the pipeline. So it is defined here. The pipeline run is called pipeline tutorial run, and it's connected to a service account. And it specifies the source repo, the two images as the resources. But before I create this, I need to create the service account as well as the permissions. We need to provide some permissions because I'm going to deploy, create a service and a deployment on this cluster. The cluster itself is a Minikube running on my computer. So it's basically a It's just permissions to create and manage ports, services, and deployments. And it also needs the Docker secret, that is credentials for my Docker repository, my Docker registry, where you can push the images and pull the images. Okay, now I can start the pipeline. Everything is set. We have created the tasks. We have created the pipeline resources. We created the pipeline. Now we can start the pipeline by creating the pipeline run. So, now the pipeline run is running, so if I try to query that. I'll see that it's running. So if I want to see the logs from this pipeline run, if I use the kubectl CLI, I will have to find the name of the port and then get the logs from there. Instead of that, what I can use is the tkn CLI, that's the command line tool for Tekton. So if I use a tkn CLI, I can use it on the resources pipeline, pipeline run, tasks, and task run. So if you So what's happening is it has cloned. One second. Yeah, so it successfully cloned the first repository, and now it's actually building the image of the app image. It's also building the web image. It will take a few minutes. So in the meantime, let me show you the Tekton CLI. Right now, it can work on task, task run, pipeline, and pipeline run. The commands, subcommands available are in the task. You can list the tasks. And in task run, it will list and log the logs from that particular task run. And with pipeline and pipeline run, these are the subcommands available. So there's a recent addition called the start command in Tekton pipeline. So what it will do is it will let you create a pipeline run without writing a YAML. So if you have a pipeline, you can specify the resources, parameters, etc. on the command line and then trigger a pipeline run. So it might take some time. So what I have is I have a separate namespace where I have deployed this already. So if once the pipeline runs, it will build the images, it will deploy the deploy the two web services. So if I use kubectl. This is what you will see. After building the images, the Tekton Tekton pipeline run will build the image and then pass the image to the deploy step, and it will create these two deployments. So if I do,
Oh, it's almost over. Yeah, thanks. Yeah. So, in fact, I'm not nervous, but my body betrays me sometimes. Yeah. So basically, what happened is we queried the service. So we called the first web service, and then it called the web service 2, which is app, and got a response and replied it back to us. So here, if I do. You see what happened with the other. Yeah. So this is what you will see if the pipeline runs successfully. You will see that in the end, all the steps will pass, and then you will see that the build has been completed successfully. So that is how you build a pipelines create a CI/CD pipeline using Tecton pipelines. So one last thing I want to add to this is that so in Red Hat, I work on a project called a pipeline operator for Tecton pipelines. So how many of you are familiar with Operator SDK or Kubernetes operators? Okay. Yeah. So basically, Kubernetes operator is a way to create your custom controllers. So it will let you create your custom CRDs and controllers. So the idea is you can embed operator logic into code. That is, so if I see there's a human CI/CD operator, and if there are repetitive things that we do, so we can embed that into code, and we can encapsulate that into a controller. So we have created a pipelines operator for Tecton pipelines. So the main advantage is that, so this, what you see is OpenShift, a Kubernetes offering from Red Hat. And what we have here is a operator catalog. So our operator provides a as a service experience for the pipelines. So it will look like an app store. And from there, you can click and pipelines can be installed. So it's still under progress. So as a summary, Tecton gives you Kubernetes style resources to manage your CI/CD API operations, and it has a controller which will manage it for you. So you can find these projects at these links. Thank you.